Hi there. Question. What should I do if I just received a 1099-C form from a creditor? Hi there. My name is Alberto from AlbertoCleansCredit.com. I am a non-attorney spokesman. Let's find out three quick things that you must do ASAP if you received a 1099-C form from a creditor. But first of all, if you're trying to fix your credit on your own, or if you're trying to, if you're thinking of hiring someone, if you want some information on how to reestablish, to rebuild your credit, or just ways to fight these crazy debt collectors on what you should be able to do if they're contacting you, hit the subscribe, like button. I would love to send you information regarding those subjects, okay? So, but let's jump right into it. Three things you must do right away if you received a 1099-C form. Yes, that's C as in cat, C as in Charles, C, more importantly, C as a cancellation of debt. So yes, somewhere out there, you're no longer responsible for certain debt. Okay, and on that form, it'll tell you if it's Citibank, Bank of America, it'll tell you. So the good news is you no longer owe that debt. That debt is no longer owned by you. The bad news is that you might owe money to the IRS. What happens is a 1099-C is basically telling you that the IRS is telling you basically that any debt that has been discharged, canceled, forgiven, it is taxable income. So the first thing that you need to do, yes, it's taxable income. The first thing you need to do is you need to forward a copy of that 1099-C to your accountant, to your tax preparer, because you don't want them to do your taxes without that. And then the IRS is going to adjust it on their own. And I can assure you, it's going to cost you more money if they do it than if your accountant doesn't and they're able to somehow play with the numbers one way or another. I am not a tax guy. But if you're planning to do taxes on your own and you got a huge 1099-C, you might want to seek professional help before you hit that button and send it to the IRS. So the first thing you need to do, give it to your tax guy. Number two, you need to pull your credit report. And yes, pull all three credit reports, TransUnion, Experian, Equifax. Pull it. Find out if that account, that Citibank account, that Chase account, whatever it is, Macy's, Pep Boys, whatever it is, that balance is reporting zero. Now, I've had creditors argue with me, their attorneys argue with me, and again, I'm not an attorney, but they've argued with me, and I've also had attorneys fight with other attorneys that my clients are being represented by, and they go, well, our clients report the balance that was charged off, but they don't really owe it. Yeah, but that's not what the credit bureau says. There's no statement that says, oh, the consumer doesn't owe it anymore because there's a 1099 that was issued. No, it has to show a zero balance. So if it doesn't show a zero, and it shows a balance there, whatever it is. Number three, you need to dispute that account with the credit bureaus. And if you're ready, I'm going to show you exactly the exact verbiage that I will use to dispute that account on the credit report if it's showing a balance. Now, if it's not showing a balance, okay, it's okay. I would still try to look for something that I might be able to dispute. I would check it, and maybe there's an issue with my last payment that I actually made. That is very important, because if they say that I made my last payment in 2017, but I made it in 2016, that's an extra year that they can keep it on my credit report. So I want to look at it. I want to look at all the information. And if I feel there's some type of discrepancies between the three bureaus or two out of the three bureaus, I'm going to let them know. I'm going to dispute it. But for this situation, I am going to write a letter of dispute. And this is how I will start the letter. This is how I would do it. First of all, date for today, you have to put your name, you have to put your address, you have to put your social, you put your date of birth. And then the verbiage, what I would do, I would put the following. The following account, if it's a Citibank, if it's a Chase, the following Chase account with Chase account number, put the account number. Credit Karma doesn't give you account number, so you might have to go to Experian, you might have to pay for a report, whatever you have to do, but you got to put the account numbers there. If maybe you know the account number from an old bill. So you say the following account, this Chase account number, such and such, is completely reporting wrong. It's reporting wrong. Enclose, and yes, you need to enclose a copy of that 1099-C form. So you're gonna say enclose is a copy of the 1099-C form that I received from this creditor. And finish saying, there should not be a balance reporting on this account. And I would say, this account needs to be deleted immediately. Now, the truth is they don't really have to delete the account. We want it to delete. We want them to delete the account. But if we don't ask, we don't get. So I would say, please delete it immediately. Then you sign it. Now, very important. So many people make mistakes when they do their own credit repairs to the credit bureaus. There's nothing wrong with that. There's a lot of good information on the internet on how to do your own disputes. There's some good companies out there. I consider myself one of the better companies, and the reason is because we're gonna look out for you. If we believe that a creditor, a collection agency, the credit bureaus have violated your rights, and I'm not an attorney, but I've been doing this for a long time. And if I can see some information, I go, wait a minute, they just violated your rights. So, you know, a lot of these credit repair companies, I'm not saying they're wrong. You know, I'm not even saying they're wrong. I honestly have to question Lexington Law sometimes because, you know, Lexington Law is a beautiful name. It's a great name. But how many clients have I taken over and I see that that the creditor's rights, the consumer rights have been violated, and they don't file a complaint on their behalf. So when I see something wrong, I'm going to say, hey, reach out to a consumer attorney in your area. And if you don't have one, I'm going to get you one. Because Experian, TransUnion, Equifax, this collection agency, this creditor just violated your rights. And which means that not only will you be able to make a couple of bucks on it, not only will, if you sued a debt collector, that debt might be completely eliminated now, but it also means that now that account can be removed off your credit report. It's a win-win situation. Plus, the best part about it is you don't have to pay an attorney. They pay the attorney. So it's a great win situation. So going back to the letter, you need to sign the letter. You need to make a photocopy of the letter. You're going to put it in an envelope and don't put a stamp on it and send it out. You can't do that. You got to take it to the post office, send it certified mail. So you're going to send it certified mail. Now, I hate to sound ridiculous, but then when I ask the client, where's the slip? Oh my God, I can't find it. I don't know what I did with it. No, you got to put everything in a manila folder, staple the certified slip on that manila folder. It's a paper trail. I have a video on why a paper trail, but it's important. So you're going to mail out that letter. You disputed the credit bureaus. Enclosed is a copy of my 1099, of a 1099-C that I received from a creditor. So now we're waiting. We're waiting about 38 days. Now, people tell me, Alberto, it's 30 days. Yeah, it's 30 days, but I always give it 4 days going, 4 days coming back, especially with the holidays and so many crazy things going on. So 38 days. I give it 38 days. In 38 days, you should have received responses from all the three credit bureaus. By the way, if one of the credit bureaus tells you, you know what, we need more information before we do the dispute, I wouldn't send them anything. I would not send them anything. Basically, if I gave them my name, my address, my social, my date of birth. I gave them a copy of the 1099-C where I am disputing. They should not hold my dispute. If they cannot verify my address, because it might be a new address, then that's fine. But that cannot stop them from doing a reinvestigation on that account. It shouldn't. And my clients have sued the credit bureaus for doing that. So here's what happens. If they send you something, I wouldn't respond to them. I would wait the 38 days, pull the credit report. And guess what? If the account is deleted, beautiful, that's fine. If the account shows a zero balance, oh, it's okay. I don't know if it's me personally, I will file a lawsuit against them because they didn't give you an actual paper trail on it. But if there's a balance still reporting, after I sent them a copy of the 1099-C and I gave them my name, my address, my social, my date of birth, and they have not removed it, well, guess what? I can take that copy of the letter, remember the letter that I made a photocopy of, that certified slip, and I will forward it to a consumer attorney in your area. And again, if you can't find a consumer attorney, I know a ton of consumer attorneys in your area. They're easy, just Google it. And any attorney in their right mind will take your case because they get paid by the violating party. So when you send them a copy of the letter and say, look, this is what I disputed. I got a 1099. It's still showing that I owe a balance. An attorney should be able to take care of that. So again, three quick things. If you get a 1099-C, give it to your accountant. Pull your credit report. And if there's a balance, number three, you want to send a dispute to the credit bureaus. And you want to wait 38 days. And if it comes back that the account has been deleted, beautiful. Your credit should have improved. Your credit overall should have improved. If it's still there, but at least it shows a zero balance. And if they're crazy enough to not at least correct it, then you actually can have a serious violation against the credit bureau that did not correct it. And sometimes I've had my clients, they'll file a lawsuit using a consumer attorney. They'll file a lawsuit against Experian, TransUnion, Equifax, and against the creditor, all four of them. Four lawsuits. Because they gave them a 1099-C and they did not correct the information on the consumer's credit report. Anyway, if you have any questions regarding this video or you would like other videos like this, hit the subscribe, like button, and I will send you information on credit repair, credit building. Send me an email to alberto@albertocleanscredit.com. Thank you so much for your precious time, and I hope that this has been informative. Thank you again, and God bless. Bye-bye.